Chef Adventures here. I'm Chef Jason. Today I'm excited. We are talking about Mirepoix. Stay tuned.
Ronnie and I'd like to take a bit to thank our subscribers. Thanks for watching. Thanks for the views and the likes and the comments. Peace.
All of these ingredients that are included in these Mirepoix are a part of the aromatic family. And when they are sauteed or sweated in the dish with butter or olive oil, they release their fragrances and their flavors into the dish that you're making. Let's talk a little bit about each one of these. This first one's a standard French Mirepoix. It consists of celery, onion, carrot. Spanish style Mirepoix, which is celery, onion, carrot, and they add tomato. Fantastic. And this is the Italian style Mirepoix, which is celery, onion, carrot, garlic, and fresh Italian parsley that they saute in olive oil. Our standard French Mirepoix is generally used in their soups. A lot of these Mirepoix are first cooked, reduced, cooked in with the food, whether it be rice, chicken, beef, all the above. White Mirepoix, where in some recipes and foods, the colors of the carrots and the celery are undesired. Parsnips is a substitute for the carrot, and leeks are a substitute for the celery. You would use that in cream sauces, some recipes, as far as cream gravies, and or bisque. One more Mirepoix we haven't touched base on is the Cajun Mirepoix. And the Cajun Mirepoix consists of onion, celery, carrot, and green pepper. Do it in their gumbos, in their shrimp dishes, that wonderful, the good stuff. I could go on and on and on and on about the awesomeness of Mirepoix. I love it. But why don't we get into the next step of preparing Mirepoix? The cutting, styles, sizes, and applications of the Mirepoix. Let's talk about preparing Mirepoix for stocks. Stocks and braises. If you're cutting Mirepoix for those style of dishes, you want big cuts. Let's talk about braising. Let's say you're gonna braise something for 12 hours. This is the style cuts you want. You want some large cuts. So, that off. You cut like a carrot up like that. Celery. Onions, cut out the top and bottom. You want big cuts. These are going to be in your, say, your crock pot style dishes. If you're cooking something in the oven for, you know, 6+ hours, 12 hours slow cooking, you want big cuts. So your Mirepoix then don't become turn into nothing. So that's kind of the stock slash braising style and size of the Mirepoix you're looking for. You know, cuts you're going to use for things that take about 3 hours from beginning to end, such as beef tips. Maybe you're cooking your Thanksgiving turkey about 3 hours, 3.5 hours, and you want more sizes like this. This way they don't deteriorate while you're cooking. They're smaller cuts, they're not as large. You'll get their flavors without them being disintegrated in your dish. So, sizes like this is more of the medium. Hour cooking time, you're going to want pieces about this size. You can see, you can use this, like I said, for your beef tips, chicken, poultry. This is your style. That's a medium cut. That's about a 3-hour dish. All right, everybody, we've been talking about large cuts for braising, 12-hour plus cookings, medium cuts for things such as poultry, beef tips, like 3-hour cooking. Now we're gonna talk about the small cuts, more of the 45-minute dishes, say your soups or your fusses. Sometimes this kind of style cooking, because it's quicker, is also pureed to use as a thickener in your soup. All right, so let me demonstrate for you. This is how you make fine cuts. We'll start first with celery. Take your celery, cut it in half. Cut it in half. Cut it in half the long way. Take it. That's a fine cut celery. Next, we'll do the carrot. I like to cut my carrot right down the center, keep your knife hand on top of the knife, flip them over, grab it, do it again, grab them, chop them. That's a fine diced carrot. Last but not least, our onion. Fine dice onion. One half onion, one part carrot, one part celery. That is your basic mirepoix, and add them to your dishes. They're delicious. You're gonna love them. Their flavor profiles build your dishes, and have fun. Honey and I like to take a moment to thank our subscribers. Thanks for all the views. Thanks for the likes and the comments. Keep them coming. Thanks for joining our party. Peace.
Food is fun.